The first song I remember that came to my mind, even though God said, when you get there, there will be three songs that will be sung. Then you will know I've been there before you. And today, I don't think I relate with anybody in that barricade. Last Friday when I saw Israel, we did not even talk. I did not even tell him I'm coming here. But to my greatest surprise, that hymn, 303, then 537 and 682, they followed each other. Those are the three songs. So which means the Spirit of God is still dwelling in Celestial Church of Christ. Then why are you troubled? Why are you moving from one church to another? Many celestials have left their glory and they have moved away. And they are out there crying. Some left in crisis. And you know, the thing they are saying out there is that the shepherd caught me. They do this, they do that. Not knowing that they have left their glory and they moved to a different church. And unless they come back. Hallelujah. Sometimes we go through troubles, problems, but we forget that there is no way we won't have problems. When you are born, the nurses and the doctors will be waiting for the placenta to come out. Even though the child is hurt, it means we are bound with problems. And sometimes, most of the time, in that problems, in that storming period, when you start farm and you can think very well, your situation, the way to your blessing, the solution to your problem is in that problem. But because we cannot think in time of trouble, when little things happen, our heart, we just go in disarray. For us to gather ourselves together, we become a very serious problem. And we put in that problem on people, forces from home. No. God wants you to think in that situation you are. Think deep. Open your eyes. The solution to your blessing, the way, the route to your glory is in that situation. Before I move further, I would like to touch the two lessons of today. Even though God said, when you get there, I will minister to you what you are going to tell my people. But the two lessons of today is not something I can just wave away without touching them. The first lesson, Zephaniah chapter 2, I'm just going to read the first three verses, which is calling us to repentance. The Bible said, we have all sinned and come short of the glory of God. Nobody is perfect. No one is holy. If God, if Christ should come through that door now to judge every one of us, who among us can raise up his hand that he or she will be worthy before the Lord? We have sinned in various ways. Some of us, when we done with our service, instead of you going home with your blessing, you sit down out there talking about people, and you don't know, by saying that, Satan is robbing you of your glory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There are some people, they are the children of covenant, no matter what they do, that covenant is still on them. And when you curse them, because of that covenant, that God says, when you curse, whoever that curse you, I will curse them.
Yes.
So, Celestians, my brothers and sisters, we have to be very, very careful. Zephaniah chapter 1, verse chapter 2, verse 1 to 3. Please.
Gather yourself.
Together.
Together.
O undesirable nation.
Before the decree is issued.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
My brothers, my sisters, gather yourself together. Wake up from your slumber. Reverse from that sin. Embrace the true path of Christ before that decree is issued. My prayer today for every one of us that is present here is that the wrath of the Lord will never be upon us.
Amen.
Let us wait, man.
The day passes like now. Before the Lord fierce anger comes upon you.
Yes.
Before the day of the Lord's anger
comes
upon you. Seek the Lord. All you seek of the earth. Who have upheld his justice. Seek righteousness. Seek humility. It may be that you will be hidden in the day of the Lord's anger.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's like the third verse. That says, seek the Lord, O ye meek of the earth. And only really. I want only Teriba. I want to know Biraga. Many of us, our glory are moving far away from us. Even the blessings of God is moving away from us because we are just too arrogant. What do you have? People do have money, they forget the way they enter into celestial church. And God opened the door for them. He blessed them. And the next thing is to now wage war against that God that blessed them. My brother and my sisters, no wonder many celestials are suffering. Yet they are blaming people for that problem. Brethren, please let us reverse back. Do away with sins. Let us embrace the path of Christ. Let us remember the origin of celestial church, where love dwells and banded people together. In one spirit we worship. Even these days, how many times do we worship God? Is it not that God is worshiping us now? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Many of us, if you look back, the way you enter into this church is through one problem or the other. Kusenit o fi rorun wo. Afeniti a bisi be. Eni ta bisi be gan. Ogun olupa wo bi e wo be. My sisters, we have to be very, very careful. And want to be a sheba. Do what is good in the sight of God. Because the wrath of the Lord will not be upon us. Hebrew chapter 3. I need the first three verses.
Wherefore?
Holy brethren. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Partaker of what?
Heavenly calling.
Akuko gagarawa kumore laga. Celestia ijo otoni. It's a mystery church from heaven. No wonder nobody can know the secret behind that glory. Want to wa mo ri ki but awata wa ni bi awo mo ye. We rubbish the glory of God. We have to be very, very careful. Can somebody quickly open Revelation chapter 3? I want you to read from verse 4 to 5. So that you will know where you are. Chapter 3, man.
You have a few names written in Sardis.
We have what?
You have a few names written in Sardis.
Uh-huh.
Who have not defiled their garments.
Those who have not defiled their garments.
And they shall walk with me in white.
They shall walk with me in white.
Amen. For they are worthy.
For they are worthy.
He who overcomes shall be clothed in white garments.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How are you, Hashem, Lord? How are you, Hashem, God? Nitori alamete wale o Jesu. How are you, Hashem, Lord?
Aja Shekun Lord.
How are you, Hashem, Lord? Who are those people that were clothed in white? The overcomers. I want to be born Ogun. I want that if he will be so to so see. And at the end of the day, Ogun got deliver.
Thank you.
They must.
Arab ni no lua. Itomi mo si wa si be si. Ko ti yi pada. That miracle is still here. People still testify to the glory of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But you see here in America. Hey, are we worshiping God? Are we a true celestials? Tell me, how many Wednesday service have you observed since the beginning of this year? Tell me, how many of Friday service have you observed? Even the Sunday service. Many of us will come in 12 o'clock. Some will come in 11 o'clock. We arise where we walk. At our place of job, when they said two, that is the time you need to function.
That's right.
Most of us will be there 1:30. But why do we now rubbish our God? Why do we not appreciate God that has given you that strength to do that work? Why as you not appreciate Him that has been blessing you? He has been protecting you. Even against all odds, he's taking care of your children, taking care of your husband and your wife. When people look at your faces, they see joy. Yet you do not appreciate that God. We forsake Him. We rubbish Him because when you come late to service, it means you rubbish God. Okay, that's all it is. I got to suit it up. When the jingle bell was rang before you came, before you are here, all the money pay a balakoti son. Those angels that were here for the jingle bell, they would just write the names of those people that are present, and immediately after the third one, they move away. May God forgive us.
Amen.
Hebrews 3 verse 1 to 3. When you read, it's telling us how powerful is Christ. I think I'm on.
Yeah, already.
Okay, go ahead.
Wherefore? Holy brethren.
Uh-huh.
Partaker of the heavenly calling.
Yes.
Consider the apostle and high priest of our profession.
Yes.
Christ Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Who was faithful to him that appointed him.
Hallelujah. Who was faithful to him that appointed him? Who is he that appointed him? God Almighty.
Yes.
That is the Father. Then are we faithful to Christ? No. He died for me and you. He died so that your enemies will not be able to kill you. He suffered so that you will not suffer. But yet, the price, the reward we need to give him is disobedience.
As also Moses was faithful in all his house.
Yes.
For this man was counted worth of more glory than Moses.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Inasmuch as he who has given.
Hallelujah, man. Is comparing, you see, among all the prophets, all the men of God that was sent, God did something that surprised me. Among all of them, apart from Elijah that was carried away in the chariot to heaven, but you remember he came back as John the Baptist to obey his price. Only Moses. You can never read your Bible from Genesis to the end. You won't see his burial ground. Nobody mentioned where he was buried. Because if they do, after so they know this one. But yet, the Bible is telling us that even Christ is more worthy than him. Then, Carlos of Paul, Baba, why are you afraid? I don't want. God bless you.
Amen.
So from here, I'm moving a little bit to my message to you through God. The message of God to you guys today. Many of us are suffering. But we could not think. No wonder the Bible said, my people perished. Because what?
Lack of knowledge.
They lack knowledge. Take for example, if there is no, let's use Nigeria, our home country, as an example, and I will compare it with America. In which country? Among the two countries that generator business is moving very fast.
Nigeria.
Nigeria. Huh? Nigeria. Nigeria. Why?
Because they don't have
the life. We have what?
Power.
Outrage. But you know that even in that crisis, that many are complaining, they are crying. It's too hot here. It's too hot there. Too much mosquito because their fan could not blow. They don't have generator. Some people think deeply in that crisis and they invest in the business of generators. And many millionaires were raised through that. So why don't you think, even in your own situation, to bring something out and you will see your solution to your problem, the root to your blessing is right beside you. Joseph, we all know his story. Some of us even know better than the preacher. But today, I'm using that as an example, and I'll be pointing out to some things, maybe while reading them, you just read past without
knowledge.
Observing the importance of that place. Joseph, we all know his position in the family, but yet he has that covenant of God upon him. We have children of promise, we have children of covenant. Children of promise, there is difference between them and children of covenant. Omo Ileri, it has condition. Toba Sin, I'll book you for it. Toba Shili, I will give you this. But Omo Ileri, Majem, abi akosowo ti mori ko se to kan lohun. When you are looking for an example of that, go and read the story of David. He was a sinner. He dipped his hands in so many things. What God hated most, he did it. He killed, he shed blood. Yet he was forgiven. But promising child, if he doesn't meet up with that condition, those glory will be lost. Why don't you examine yourself? Whether you are a promising child or a covenant child. Can somebody just open Genesis? I think that should be chapter 37, I think. I want you to start from verse 8.
And his brother said to him, Can you indeed bring over us?
Mommy, there might be no man. For them to be able to understand, can you start from verse 5? Yes.
Now Joseph had a dream.
He had a dream.
And he told it to his brothers. And they hated him evermore.
They hated him just because of what? Of his dream. Many of us. Has put you in that mess you are today. When you had a dream, you share it with people. When a prophet or a prophetess called you out there and they gave you a message, yet you come out. You have to be very, very careful. That is what you want.
So he said to them, please hear this dream, which I have dreamed.
Yes.
There we were, binding sheaves in the field.
In the field.
Then behold, my sheaf arose and also stood upright. And indeed, your sheaves stood all around and bowed down to my
Hallelujah. What is he trying to tell his brothers? By your favor, go in my deliver for me. Share, God will be happy.
No.
Oh. When you know your position. So that is why, my brothers and sisters, we need to seal our mouths. Keep your mouth shut. That is the first point where Celestia do face problems. That is what you are saying.
And his brother said to him, shall you indeed reign over us? Or shall you indeed have dominion over us?
Yeah.
So they hated him even more for his dream and for his words. Then he dreamed still another dream and told it to his brother and said, look, I have dreamed another dream. And this time, the sun, the moon, and the devil stars
Hallelujah. You see, the first one, even though they hated him, they didn't make any move. They didn't do anything. They just hated him. But this second one now, okay, we shall see. And they started planning. Can you just go to 21 down a little bit? 21.
Had it, and he delivered him out of their hand and said, let us not kill him.
That was after they have decided, okay, we are going to kill him. But you know, that covenant is still there. And God speaks through them. And when he speaks, they listen to him. Because God is speaking through him. And they all abide with what he said.
And who then said to them, shed no blood.
Yeah.
But cast him into this pit, which is in the wilderness.
You see, he gave them an option. Because he had a different motion. After all said and done, we all knew how he passed through, how he was sold to those people, how he went to Egypt and he became a slave. How the master's wife tried to friend him, come and sleep with me, and he said no. If Joseph happens to be me and you, free cake. I know the man. Kia, but it's Bamu. Many celestial men, we have lost our glory. It will be fire like that. Hello, people. Not all women that you see, you have to sleep with. Some men are so bad, anything that is in skirt, they can't hold themselves. They are so useless, even their sister, they can sleep with that. So do it. That is another thing from where many of us have lost their glory. May God restore every lost glory.
Amen.
Then he ended up in jail, even though he never committed that sin, yet he ended up in jail. But you know, like I said earlier, in that situation, that is where his worth, the way to his greatness is.
Yes.
And right in that place, he met who? Two of Pharaoh's staff that were there. And they said he had a dream. When you go to Genesis 40, start from verse 12. Genesis chapter 40, verse 12.
And Joseph said to him, this is the interpretation of it.
Yeah.
The three branches are 3 days.
3 days.
Now within 3 days, Pharaoh will lift up your head and restore you to your place.
Yes.
And you put Pharaoh's cup in his hand according to the Roman manner. Then you were his butler. But remember me when it is well with you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Remember me when it is well with you. Did you remember him?
Yes.
No.
Later.
Oh, she bought a bayo ya yo shegunti eni. God damn you, la ye ma rotin in je kilo kon. But you know what God did? He never sleep just because of Joseph. Because of your situation, God will never sleep.
Amen.
That is it you believe.
I believe.
Tori orwe, Olorun o su. Oni ohun to ma fi ohun ti o logun da mo awon logun. Ala lasan. Olorun fi trouble Pharaoh just because he's taking somebody to his greatness. Lonely, because you have that privilege to be here today and listen to the word of God, that Lord will never sleep upon your situation.
Amen. Jesus' name.
And believe it, whether you like it or not, before this year runs out, you will be back here to testify to the word of God.
Amen. Jesus'
name.
Lonely, 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 lonely. Lodi, 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 lodi
what happened? He troubled Pharaoh just because of one person. I know many celestials are in this country. They don't have papers. Many have been here years upon years. They have struggled within their own strength to get it. Yet it's not forthcoming. I know you bring it. Just because they want that paper, by all means. I know you coin. No, bring it to 5,000 mumaga, 10,000 mumaga. He will pay that money when it is just a little time for him to get it. That woman will start crisis. And what happened? No way. But today, I am telling you, if you believe in the Lord, right down to these days, because of you, the government of this country, they will change their constitution. You think it's not possible?
It's possible.
If because of Joseph, Pharaoh could not sleep. Because of your situation, for you to have your papers in this country, Obama will never sleep. And even the Senate, the House, they will listen to him when he speaks. You see, there is power in celestial church. We are losing because we do not appreciate the kind of God we have. Before, because we belittle the power of our God. He's able, abundantly able
to deliver. And to say, who is able, abundantly able to deliver those who trust in Him? He's able, he's able, abundantly able to deliver.
Trust in Him.
Oh, yes.
If you trust the Lord,
amen,
for the power that resides, that reigns in this church, you will see the glory of God.
Amen.
Amen. Be all my yoga one long. Only go at one time. If you worship God the way He should be worshipped, Sunday service is for God to renew and to restore our glory. Then when you come in late, the jingle bell has been rang before you come. What happened? That is when Ogun Ibile ya gan agbo aniba o ona olufe gbigba. Wednesday service, we have two services on Wednesday. 9 o'clock in the morning for those who are sick for the favor of God. Even in the evening on Wednesday, you have the evening service. Like I asked us earlier on, how many of us, how many of those services have you observed or attended since the beginning of this year? So let's change our ways. When we move closer to God, God will move to closer to us. Amen. It's not far from us.
Hallelujah.
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 Jesus, no, 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 no,
That's your man. God bless you.
Amen.
The Lord is come. And all odds. Did Joseph never rise to power? He rise to power. God lifted him up. Let's go to Genesis 41. Let's start reading from 37. 41, 37.
So the advice was good.
The advice he gave to Pharaoh, that is the king. You see, for him to have been able to get to that position of advising the king, and at that time, not just the king of Egypt, he's so powerful. But yet, Joseph happened to be an advisor. And that is not where God is taking him to. Not just an advisor.
And in the eyes of all his servants.
And in the eyes of all his servants.
And Pharaoh said to his servants,
Can
we find such a one as they? A man in whom is the Spirit of God.
Hallelujah. In whom is the Spirit of God. And he told me and me alone. In there you are at issue having home. What my journey money you are. In Jebi Ashen Shinita, do we present ourselves as a good ambassador of this church? Ask yourself that question. Share me alone on Benin. Woloma bring your Benin line. About where the twisted on where you come and up a sister for like a woman with my boom. We have for like a year. Have I been enjoying it? It's just an example, please. So, you see, we have to behave ourselves as an ambassador of Christ. Sometimes, people ask me, which church do you go and when you say Celestial Church? One day I ask them, Kini Yatomori Dim at the Celestial Church. They be mama wa humble. They are polite. They do this. They do as well. You come to Celestial Church and see that glory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
No wonder he be to just pull my boss show them boss to my boss to another level. My back on the church. So we have to be very, very careful at your place of job. Nothing, nobody can even touch you. Oh, the baby kakomola, you fire back. I hate nonsense. Bullshit. I want to you come and tell no more long time. After that, kill officially.
Then Pharaoh said to Joseph,
yes.
Inasmuch as God has shown you all this.
Inasmuch as God has shown you all this, which means in you, there is a gift that God has given you. If you use it well, it will take you to your glory. You will move into your glory.
Amen.
A put a fellow me is called Adura. Adura, I meant that when you pray, people will feel that impact. They will feel the presence of God. And as they felt that, God is doing wonders in your own life. But you are the one that will come late or you will not even show up. The gift of another person may be, you know, sitting down there and praise God, sing, and let people dance. And when they are dancing, good things will be happening in your life. But most of us, you forget that church, the Lord Church David. You see, we fight. Many harvests. In Jale Lumi Ma Fapari. America and Motin Lini. But you call it Shia. Ma Pura Obe Ni Lain. Is it good? We need to present ourselves as an ambassador of Christ. You Do you know when you worship God and you are worthy before Him, He will bless you even beyond your own imagination. And when you are blessed, the season will cooperate with you. Even the moon and the sun, they will cooperate. For sure. The Bible confirmed that. Can somebody open Joshua 10? Joshua 10, 12 to 13. Joshua 10, verse 12 to 14.
Then Joshua spoke to the Lord.
And Joshua spoke to the Lord.
In the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites,
before
the children of Israel.
Yes.
And he said in the sons of Israel.
Yes.
Son stand still over.
Strong, stand still. He's commanding his son to stand still.
Over Gideon.
Over Gideon.
And moon in the valley of Aijalon. So the sun stood still. And the moon stopped. Because the people had revenge upon their enemies.
Hallelujah. You know what? If you worship God, I will like that. He will empower you. He will give you His divine power. He will empower your tongue. When you say go, it will go. When you say come, it will come. Awala amo yarawa. Ashota amoyi. You struggle for rank in Celestial Church of Christ. Like you, Pimmy. Everybody wants to wear pink. They want to be Mother Celestial. And when the shepherd gives them that grace, I want to bad what you, they will never respect them. And he told you, the Mother Celestial at here, we are 2000. At what to bat here, in 2013. Oh, you want to the bat here. Nikki. So we have to respect. That is why the Bible said humility. He's calling on the meek. Let's respect each other. That is, we must humble, we must honor those who honor us at you. May God forgive Celestia.
Yeah.
But no matter what, me, I'm part and parcel of Celestial Church.
Me too.
Multiple on damage, and I'll never look back.
Amen. Me too.
I'm not here because of rank. I'm not here to see what people are doing. I'm here to worship God and do the right thing before God. May God bless every one of us.
Amen.
Let's go into a very brief revival, but before then we have to welcome our